I absolutely adore teaching singing, and I teach all sorts of different demographics and different situations. People will come to me, they may be aspiring to be one of the best opera singers, or they may be aspiring to even give a speech at a wedding or something like that. So it's all kind of vocal production and finding your voice and finding your natural, easy, comfortable way to do things. When a student comes to me, each one is different and will need something very different. So really at the first almost consultation lesson that we have, they may not be aware that it is a consultation, they will show me their own assessment in a way, because I have to see how I can help them. And I will definitely have a different agenda and development for each person.
Sylvia has been an absolutely excellent facilitator. She has always had a very clear way of expressing what the fairly complex process of singing actually is. She has the ability to work across all age groups. She has worked with kids aged from 5 right up to adults. So she has an innate ability to put across in a very simple way what it is she wants you to understand about the process of singing. She has a great sense of humour, very entertaining, and has a very, very good way of demonstrating what it is that she wants you to do. She has a fantastic voice herself, of course, and she has such a huge wealth of experience from all her training and from all her performance experience as a singer herself. I have always loved working with Sylvia. She's just great fun. She is one person you know you will always get an honest opinion about what it is that you're looking for with your singing. She will never tell you a lie, and she will tell you exactly how far you can go and how far you can't go. So, as far as I'm concerned, you will always get exactly what you need from Sylvia.
It's a very nice feeling for all of us when the realization dawns on everyone in the room that actually somebody's core natural sound is the much more desirable sound than something that seems to be put on by an imitation of an opera singer, and that goes for every single style. If you are singing pop songs, you need to sing with your own voice in as natural a way as possible for people to be really moved and for it to touch the listener.
I think the main problem for trained singers is that we have so much language, we have so much knowledge about our art form that very often it gets confused, or we do things and we're not quite sure why we're doing them anymore. So when I went to Sylvia, she stripped away a lot of the mystery which is associated with classical singing and spoke in very simple, very plain language that I was able to understand and implement immediately.
Very often the sessions are almost like counselling, but it's really necessary because the whole being is the sound. That's not to say that people have to reveal their darkest secrets or all their past history or anything like that. They don't. But they definitely have to feel very physically comfortable so that the sound will start to come.
Down by the Sally Garden.
Okay, just as that phrase is rising, it's sort of going a little bit nasally because the air is being lost.
Yeah.
But what I'd like you to do is lift the air up to kind of open that phrase.
Down by the Sally Gardens, my love and I did meet.
Very good. Just one more thing. Don't lose air by going, my love and I,
my
love and I. Recently, I have been teaching workshops to singing teachers, and I find that's a revelation. And we work on finding the way back to the natural voice. I have a very strong view that the more complex something is made, the less you will achieve at the end. If you look at a small child, they all know how to sing. They all know how to breathe properly. They all know how to use their voice in the world. And my hope is to return people who are going through this journey of life, to return them to this natural state of being able to use their voice without impediment.